Hey, Kate from Apify here. Today we're going to talk about blocking and proxies. If you've ever attempted web scraping, you've probably encountered situations where the websites you were trying to scrape blocked your access. Although this can be frustrating, there are effective methods to prevent blocking, and one of them is using proxies. In this video, we'll learn how to choose the right proxy, demonstrate how to send requests using proxies, and explore why rotating them can substantially increase the reliability of your web scrapers. There are many factors you should consider when choosing a proxy type and provider for web scraping. For example, how sophisticated are the anti-scraping methods of your target website? What is the number of web pages we want to scrape? And of course, what's your budget? The type of proxies most prone to getting blocked are data center proxies. They're easier to get blacklisted, but they're also cheaper. In many cases, they work just fine for your project. However, for websites that have advanced bot detection mechanisms, you might need to use either mobile or residential proxies. By the way, if you're interested in knowing more about the different types of proxies, check out the resources in the description below. So now that we know that using proxies can make our scrapers more reliable and less prone to getting blocked, let's see how we can send a request using a proxy. In this example, we added an authenticated proxy to the JavaScript HTTP client got and put it inside a loop to simulate multiple requests to the same URL. Notice the country US groups residential username in the Apify proxy URL. Most modern proxy services allow configuration of the proxy through the username. In this case, country US means that only proxies from the United States will be chosen, and groups residential limits the selection to residential proxies. To make this code example work, you need to replace the password placeholder with your actual Apify proxy password. Your free Apify account already gives you access to the residential proxy group. If you don't have an Apify account yet, you can follow the link in the description to register. Once you are logged in to Apify, go to Proxy HTTP Settings. Copy your proxy password and paste it in the code. Note that the IP addresses are different from the address you'd get by directly accessing the URL from the browser. This confirms that the proxy is working and masking the IP addresses from the bot requests. One more thing you might have noticed is that some of the proxy requests logged different IP addresses. This is because the Apify proxy automatically rotates through the proxies available in the proxy pool. Proxy rotation means that your scrapers will switch the IP addresses they use to access websites between requests. This makes the request seem like they're coming from different users, making your bot look less like a bot. In other words, using proxy rotation reduces the chance of blocking by making the scraper's actions seem like the behavior of a user. That's all for this tutorial. But if you want to keep learning about using proxies and other tricks to avoid getting blocked when scraping the web, take a look at our article, Web Scraping: How to Crawl Without Getting Blocked. The link is in the description below. So long, and thanks for all the likes.